I will theoretically see how the signal from the UART can be received by the SPI. The wiring and software for bidirectional communication between SPI and UART are described in the following video. SPI and UART bidirectional communication support only half-duplex due to SPI characteristics. Use an external interrupt or pin change interrupt to detect the start bit. SPI can use four data transfer modes by setting the polarity and phase of clock as shown in the figure. Mode 0 and Mode 3 sample the data at the SCK rising edge, and Mode 1 and Mode 2 sample the data at the SCK falling edge. In the figure, 8-bit data is transmitted and received, but data bits may be transmitted and received selectively up to a maximum of 16 bits. In general, SPI supports MSB first but may support both MSB first and LSB first. In master mode, write the data to be sent to the SPI data register and wait until the transmission is completed. Alternatively, a transfer complete interrupt may be used. If the SPI is sent from the UART and it is set to master mode to read the signal and LSB first, it is set to LSB first. Since the UART supports LSB first communication, if the SPI supports only MSB first, it must transmit by bit reverse before transmitting, and the received data must also be bit reversed. If the SPI supports 8 bits of communication, 7 data bits, no parity and 1 stop bit are used, since the start bit and data bits must be transmitted, received at a time. If your SPI supports more than 8 bits of communication, you can use 9 data bits, odd or even parity, and 2 stop bits. The speed of SPI SCK is set to MCU clock divide by 32 or slower SCK. In UART, the baud rate is set according to the set SPI SCK. To read the signal from the UART, the SPI first uses an external interrupt or pin change interrupt to detect the start bit so that the interrupt is triggered at the falling edge. The external interrupt or pin change interrupt should use the highest priority possible. If the priority of the external interrupt or pin change interrupt is low, it may happen that the correct data cannot be read because the CPU execute other interrupt code at that time, as shown in the figure. When an interrupt occurs at T0, start bit 0xFF is written in the SPI data register. Disable the external interrupt or pin change interrupt until the transmission is completed. Writing 0xFF to the SPI data register has no effect because the UART RX pin connected to the MOSI pin maintains the idle state, logical high. Since SPI performs both write and read simultaneously, it also means sampling SPI MISO signal connected to UART TX pin. That is, if 0xFF is written to the SPI data register at T0, sampling starts from that point after half cycle of SPI SCK. Wait until SPI data transfer complete, T2. If SPI data transfer complete, T2, enable external interrupt or pin change interrupt and prepare to receive the next start bit. For example, suppose the UART sends binart data 00001111. If the SPI is set to MSB first, the SPI must receive binary 0111100 and reverse it to make binary 00001111 the UART sent. If the SPI is set to LSB first, the SPI must receive binary 0001110 and shift it by 1 bit to make binary 0001111. I hope this helps your project.